Painting portraits is my passion. I'm John Myatt, an artist, and I've been commissioned to paint famous people. But these will be no ordinary portraits, and I'm no ordinary painter. I used to be an art forger. I was jailed for forging over 200 paintings, a crime that rocked the art world, and I paid the price for it. I did my time, and now I make an honest living painting legitimate fakes in the style of famous artists. I'm copying the great masters to create my celebrity portraits, but I'm up against the clock. I have less than a day to do each one. And today, my sitter is pop legend Robin Gibb. Robin Gibb was one of the Bee Gees alongside his elder brother Barry and twin Morris. They started in the 60s and are still one of the world's top-selling bands. They've sold more than 220 million records worldwide, and between them have written over 900 songs, with hit singles spanning five decades. When they all should
let us be. I'm at the gatehouse of Robin Gibb's beautiful 13th century mansion in Oxfordshire, a distinguished setting for a distinguished portrait. I've decided to paint Robin in the style of Vincent van Gogh, but in true rock star fashion, Robin doesn't actually get up until around about midday. But that gives me a chance to have a good look around.
Wow, I know this is just one of Robin's houses. It's steeped in history. Apparently Henry VIII once stayed here. Well, you can't tell. Very own stone circle. Oof. And his own personal chapel. Robin lives in this medieval mansion with his second wife and their son. What a dining room. Enough snooping. Now, I really need to get on with it and find a place to paint. There's just one room left, and it's the old 14th century refectory.
Oh, boy. This is beautiful. Now, this is the place. This is it. This is where we're going to do the painting. Right here.
This is a really exciting moment for me. I've always been a Bee Gees fan, and I'm quite nervous about finally meeting one in the flesh.
It's getting on already, nearly 2:30. So that's my big worry today, that the light changes completely and that the colours change with it.
Hello.
Mr. Gibb.
How are you? Robert.
John Myatt.
Good to see you. Good to see you, John.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming.
Oh, thank you for coming. Gosh. Now, shall we go and...
Certainly shall.
So, if you can, yeah. Robin, get comfortable on this chair.
Yeah, because it's a long time, isn't it?
It's
one position.
It is, actually. Yeah. And, of course, you'll have rest. But what we need to do, if you know what you're going to do with your hands...
Yeah.
Comfortable with your hands. Yeah. What you don't need is pins and needles. So, that's nice.
And watch your children.
That's nice, actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's nice.
Yeah, I kind of feel comfortable like this.
You do? That's lovely, actually.
Statesman-like.
I'm going to paint you in the style of Vincent van Gogh.
Okay.
Who thought that the portrait was the most elevated form of art that there was. Most of his portraits took between 2.5 and 3 hours in a sitter. He couldn't find sitters quite often.
Right.
His problem was that people didn't like him. He was acutely smelly and very eccentric.
Born in Holland in 1853, Vincent van Gogh was a tortured soul who suffered from huge mood swings. This is reflected in his art, which can be wild and excessive or beautifully controlled. Amazingly, van Gogh taught himself to paint and draw. He sketched for a whole year before touching a paintbrush, so keen was he to excel. I've chosen van Gogh for Robin because the Bee Gees were such a colorful band, and van Gogh is best known for his use of color.
This is going to be lovely.
I wonder what tips Robin has for someone starting out.
A lot of people say to me today that are just entering, how do you get into the music business? And my answer is, I haven't a clue. Because I don't. We started doing this when we were about six or seven years old.
You were youngsters, weren't you?
Yeah.
When you kicked off.
So we didn't know what we were doing. We were just copying what we heard on the radio, and we challenged each other, say, let's imagine what their next record would be like. So unwittingly, we were delving into the art of composition at a very young age, which is probably the best time to do it. And
the harmonies, though.
We broke into natural harmony when we lived in Manchester, and our parents thought the radio was on because we were completely self-taught and have been completely self-taught. So we didn't know what we were doing. We were just having
really
like, as a
you
hobby.
Didn't actually know.
Didn't have a clue. We thought it was normal that people did this.
Yeah.
You know, we were just having fun as kids. But the other kids in the neighbourhood couldn't relate to it because we weren't self-taught. We didn't have musical technique. When we actually were confronted with people who did know what they were doing because they were taught, we'd play them a song, and the guy that was taught musically said, "That's musically wrong." And we'd argue. We said, "Well, it sounds right to us, so therefore it must be right."
Van Gogh worked very swiftly, and I need to do the same, so I'm using acrylics because they dry so quickly.
What kind of paint would Van Gogh use?
One of the things he's mostly famous for, of course, is actually painting, which was considered to be awful, was actually just painting straight out of the tube. He didn't mix the colour sometimes, just put it on.
For most of his career, Van Gogh followed the Dutch masters and used only muted colours. But after arriving in Paris, he was highly influenced by the Impressionists and immediately switched to the bright colours most people now associate him with. To reflect this, I'm choosing sky blue for Robin's background.
Now, for you, what was the real big one?
The high point of our lives was actually not just getting hit records or having hit records or starting to have hit records, but actually other people recording our songs.
Yes.
The Gibb brothers wrote hundreds of songs, performed by various artists including Dionne Warwick, Marvin Gaye and Beyoncé.
We've always valued ourselves as songwriters before, you know, performers. We've always thought of ourselves as songwriters. We wrote a song called Chain Reaction, for instance, for Diana Ross, and we were asking her to record it, and she said, "Oh no, I don't want to record this, because it sounds like the Supremes." And we said, "That's exactly why we wrote it, because it sounds like the Supremes. And that's why I want you to do it, because you are one of them." "Oh, well, that's why I don't want to do it."
It was her first number one in the UK for 14 years and became an international hit.
I've noticed as you're becoming more relaxed, no, that hand is going up there.
Yeah.
And that seems to me to
be quite,
I think I'm going to change my mind about the way, because I like that.
Yeah.
And it's a bit more relaxed. It means I can move the composition over here a bit more and have that. The head stays straight there. That's a lovely pose there, isn't it? Really lovely. Yeah. And also, interestingly, it just occurred to me that Van Gogh had this kind of code that people who actually did that, there's a brilliant portrait of a man called Dr. Gachet. Anyway, Van Gogh's code was that if you were like this, you know, that you were sort of a deeper, you were of a deeper spiritual sort of persuasion.
I like this man.
It's an honour to be with Robin. But with these changes and just an hour to go, I'm worried I won't pull it off in time.
From scientific research, Centrum vitamins and minerals in specially balanced combinations to help release energy from food and to help maintain healthy skin. And now introducing Centrum Fruity Chewables, the great tasting multivitamin, perfect for people on the go. Everyday multiple benefits with Centrum Advance and new Centrum Fruity Chewables. Clever you, clever Centrum.
Hi there. Look at this. Grab the weed, stand on it, pull it out, and it's done.
Mind if I try?
Go ahead.
recommend?
The Weed Puller. No weeds, no backache. Fiskars. Gardening that practically does itself.
Wow. Exactly.
Everyone seems to be promising cheaper car insurance these days. But who can find you a cheap quote in a matter of seconds? NewConfused.com Quick Quote will text you a quote straight away. Simply text your number plate to 66800, and if you've used Confused.com before, you'll receive a cheap quote in a flash. If only everything in life was so easy.
Text your number plate to 66800 for a cheap quote in a matter of seconds. Confused.com, on a mission to save you money.
Enter a new world of photography. Get the Canon EOS 600D this spring and you can claim £50 cash back. Your EOS adventure starts here.
Walk into the RHS Hampton Court Palace Flower Show and walk into a world of inspiration. It's packed with ideas for gardening and outdoor living. From the Romance and Roses Marquee to the new low-cost, high-impact gardens, you'll find a cavalcade of fascinating displays, practical help, and super shopping. Book now and save on every ticket. Join the RHS now and save even more. Walk into a world of inspiration, and who knows what you'll walk out with.
At Currys PC World, this stylish Lenovo laptop
with an Intel Pentium processor,
massive 6GB memory,
and 500GB hard drive
is £329.
170 off
at Currys PC World.
Playhouse presents Emma Thompson, Eddie Marsan, and Russell Tovey. The infamous meeting that wasn't in the Queen's diary.
Put it back. I wanted someone to talk to. And I thought, I bet she'd listen.
Listening's part of my job.
Playhouse presents Walking the Dogs, Thursday at 9 on Sky Arts 1HD.
Introducing Live TV. Now available on selected Android smartphones. Watch your favorite shows, sports, or movies, whether you're setting off or settling down. Enjoy a great lineup of TV live at your fingertips on Sky Go. Sky, believe in better.
I'm painting Bee Gees pop legend Robin Gibb in the style of Vincent van Gogh. He'll only see his portrait at the end, and I hope he likes it enough to hang it in his house. But I've just made a decision which will eat into the precious 2 hours I have left.
I have changed the composition now, which is, at this stage, not what I planned to do when I started out. It's kind of more representative of him. So I'm moving the painting about to actually take that into account. It's a thing you have to do.
As I get on with it, I want to know how Robin keeps his feet on the ground with so much wealth and success.
We've never lived the life of a celebrity. We've always kept ourselves in the studio.
Yeah.
And writing songs and always in a studio working atmosphere. We've always felt that, you know, every time we walked into a studio, we were starting out. You know, we never wanted to lose that feeling. I think it demonstrates the fact that we always did what we did for the love of it. And we never thought of any of what the financial gains might be. That was the last thing we thought about. And I think that is a part of the creative process, that you're doing it because you have to do it. It's not because you have to do it for money. You're doing it because you're doing like acting. You're doing it because it's in you to do. And it's almost therapy to do what you have to do.
Well, I'll need therapy if I don't get these proportions right.
Oh, I'm such a mess with this sleeve. I'm going to just... Right, if you can, Robin, just for a few minutes. Just
let me just... Can I have more on the face?
Or... No, it's just the cuff, as a matter of fact. I'm just wrestling with that flipping cuff. Now, there we go. I've got it now. That's where it is. Yeah. It's not there, you idiot. It's there.
It's not easy competing with such a creative genius like Vincent van Gogh. The The Bee Gees had an astonishing burst of creativity just when their careers reached a low ebb. In 2 days, they wrote 6 songs that changed their lives forever.
In 2 nights, we did Stayin' Alive, How Deep Is Your Love, Night Fever, More Than a Woman, and If I Can't Have You.
All of those songs together?
Yeah. We wrote and recorded these songs as time fillers between the mixing of a live album because we were bored and had something to do.
That's unbelievable.
At the time, their record producer, Robert Stigwood, happened to be working on the film Saturday Night Fever.
He called up and he said, what are you doing? We're mixing our live album. He said, you haven't got any songs handy for this film that we're doing. Paramount are behind it, but it's a very low-budget film. So we said, we've got these songs already written. We haven't got time to write anymore, so come over and listen to what we've got.
And the rest, as they say, is history.
It's still the biggest selling soundtrack album in the world today.
That's unbelievable. Now, having just blocked most of the composition, I'm going to work on this background area here with smaller jabs of colour and thick colour to which I think Vincent would have done. In some cases, he would have put a highly patterned background and wallpaper kind of background. But in this one, I'm just going to put vertical movements all the way up and down here, just to kind of energize the background of the painting.
Energetic and vibrant, Van Gogh's portraits capture the essence of his sitters. They also give a powerful insight into the artist's own mental state. He never stopped painting, even when dogged by fits, depression, and serious mental illness.
So, Robin, what about the lows in your life?
I would say losing my brothers, I suppose, as in any family, but particularly because we worked together.
Youngest brother Andy was a teen idol and just about to join the Bee Gees when he died suddenly of heart problems exacerbated by his drug abuse.
Losing my younger brother Andy at the age of 30 years old, almost 20 years ago now, was the first time we'd lost someone that was so close to the family, and it was very, very hard to deal with.
15 years later, in 2003, Robin's brother Morris died unexpectedly. To lose a twin must have been agonising.
Losing Morris in 2003 was probably the greatest blow of my life.
Yeah.
Morris has been dead for 5 years. Now I get moments where I can... it's not possible. I always think, you know, I could be sitting in the bath or something. I can't believe it. He's not here. He's gone. Yeah. I can't believe he's dead. You know, that, it's just totally... I don't think there's anything like the Americans have a word for it, closure. There's no such thing.
No.
You just don't think about those things that bother you. And I think that's what you do. And to me, that's what it is. I never really came to terms with it. I just don't think about it. And when I do, I just don't believe it. I just can't believe it. For me, it's better to think that he's just gone on a long holiday or that he's somewhere in the world rather than the fact that he doesn't exist.
Yeah.
As he's been talking to me, Robin's been moving and my perspectives are getting all out of whack, so I need to change things yet again.
I'm going to push it out a little bit more because it keeps on moving as Robin relaxes and it's heading towards the edge of the canvas, which is...
Oh, it's heading to the floor.
Which is interesting.
It's probably horizontal in a minute.
And what I'm going to do now, Robin, actually, is I think I'm going to move on to your face. Just establish the eyes, nose, mouth. Get these contours right. And then the last thing I want to do is to actually sculpt with the paint, to actually move the direction of the brush over the shape of the paint. But until I get the drawing something like right, I mean, it is something like right, but it's not right yet. So I'm going to slog on with these outlines until I feel Robin is arriving. He's coming.
He's on his way.
He's on his way.
He's on the number 13.
No, he is on his way, actually. Yeah. He is on his way.
I'm struggling, but even when Van Gogh had lost his sanity, he could still create a masterpiece in just a few hours. After Night Fever, their massive worldwide success kept the Bee Gees away from home for months at a time. And for Robin, that came at a price.
So we all know divorce is a very difficult time for everybody, Robin. How did you deal with yours?
When my marriage broke up, my first marriage, I wasn't a great deal at home, and I was quite young. I was consumed by my work, what I was doing, and I had two marriages at the time, my marriage to my career and my marriage to my family. And I went home one day and they had left rather than the other way around. And so it was just that I didn't spend enough time with them, and that really probably my fault. And I take full responsibility for that now. But then, you know, you can't make an omelette without breaking eggs. You've got to devote time into something if you're going to make it work. Mm. It was a few years before I got to see my two children again.
Really?
Yeah, I wish it had been sooner rather than later, but yeah, it was quite a traumatic experience.
Yeah. And how long was it before you saw the children?
5 or 6 years to see my kids after our initial separation.
And why was that?
Logistics for them, there was school. I know that, you know, family should be a priority and always expected, but when you're in the kind of business I'm in, it's a bit of a bohemian kind of existence. Mm. But I don't regret that.
You know, it has to be said, there's a certain kind of selfishness in creative people isn't particularly pleasant, but it's there.
The child ego never leaves the artist. He stays the child,
it's very true.
She,
it's true,
all their lives. Yeah. And if you lose that, you lose the creative spark, sense of wonder that the child has stays with you.
Yeah.
I think we can be more what we want to be because of we're artists than the average person.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it gives us license and therapeutically to live the lives that we want to live. And I think we are happier people because of it.
He might be happy, but at the moment, I'm not. I've added strong contrasting colours to the face, a technique Van Gogh is famous for, but it's still not right.
Damn it. Everything's right apart from the eyes, Robin. So can I ask you to just, it's not right, but it's ish. I'm going to take them out again, and if you can just sort of take that position to wherever you were looking in that thoughtful way, I'll get them out and I'll try again.
Just 10 minutes to go, and I'm really feeling the pressure now.
So far, so bad. Come on.
Van Gogh would never have been so slow. He worked at a feverish pace, sometimes finishing several paintings a day. He created over 800, but only ever sold this one in his lifetime and died in obscurity.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I mean, I quite like that look where you're actually looking down, quite sort of almost towards here, just sort of a little bit up a bit, but sort of thoughtfully. I'm going to try for that, rather
sort
than going
halfway between like that.
Yeah, rather than just looking straight at me. It was quite nice, that just pensive moment, as though you were
in just midair, like middle distance.
I've just got to have just a tiny touch more with Robin's eyes, and then I really am actually going to let him go and say thank you so much for having me. And I hope you like your painting. You're there, but I just want you to look a little bit more. I think you're more confident than I've got you looking. You're pretty good, pretty close, but I'm just...
The tweak of a brush can make or break it.
Ah, you see? I think we can just these tiny little things. And now doesn't he look better? Well, that's it. Time's run out. I think I've done all I can. Thank you ever so much, Robin. What I'm going to do is frame this painting, ask you to come back, and then tell me what you think. Thanks very much.
Thanks a lot, John.
It's been a very interesting exercise. He's been a lovely model, a lovely person to meet. I just wish I had more time.
I'm a bit nervous because painters will always see the essence of the person, and it'd be interesting to see how he sees me.
I don't know what Robin will think of it. I mean, I wouldn't even want to second guess. And up he goes. Now, Robin, your painting at long last.
Gosh. Brilliant.
What do you think?
I love it. I think it's great.
Do you really?
Yes, I do.
It was a nice moment when you actually moved your arm up like this and that, yeah. that made the painting much better for me, much easier
it's
to do.
It's something I'm more likely to do.
Yes. Yeah. You do it, actually, even in conversation, you sort of go like that sometimes.
That's right. But I love it. I think it's great. I do.
He's a nice chap, isn't he? You can tell.
You know,
he's okay, isn't he?
You've made me look better than I.
No, I haven't. I don't think so. I'm so pleased that, you know, yes. if you're happy, I'm
very
delighted.
Happy.
Well, Robin, I can't say it was a privilege just been to meet you, sir. Absolutely.
You. Thank you very much, John.
Thank you. Thanks, Robin.
I'm thrilled with it. I can see myself in this picture. If I can see myself in this picture, then he's won.
If I had longer with it, it would become more like a Van Gogh painting. But it unfortunately has a bit too much of me in it.
I'm going to hang it in the main room, in the main house.
Oh, Robin Gibb is just a legend, isn't he? I mean, he's in the music business, but he's just as interested in the music as he is in the business. I was privileged to meet that man, actually. I like him, and I admire him.